Woodwork geek back here again. This time I'm making some MDF radiator covers. I start off by creating the frame for the radiator covers by machining down the MDF into strips for the two vertical and horizontals or rails and stars for the radiator covers. It's always a good idea to have a cutting list for things like this so that you can machine all the pieces that are the same dimensions. All the vertical rails are exactly the same width. The horizontals change, but you need two of each of the horizontals, and then all of the sides are the same to make the offset from the wall to the radiator wide enough. It's worth mentioning that when you measure up for these, you want to give at least 5 centimeters height above the radiator and come out about 2 centimeters from the radiator to the inside edge of the radiator cover, otherwise the cover's going to hit. I use pocket hole joinery to keep all of the pieces together, just to keep a nice flat surface, so you can see me clamping the bit down so that when you screw the rail and stars together, it leaves that surface flush. I come back and glue these afterwards to make sure I get a decent glue joint. The second frame's done exactly the same as the first frame. Once you see the front's done there, you see me come back and then start to put the sides on. So on these I have one long side, and then I have a side where I need an opening for getting to the radiator thermostat. This short piece I'm putting on here is for the thermostat side. It just gives plenty of space to get your hand in to adjust the temperature of the radiator. You see me flicking through to the other small cover that I need to make here. I've got two smaller covers and then one large cover to make for the same client, so they all follow the same pattern with the same design. What I learned as I was going through here is that you need to use the right angle square to make sure that those what look like uprights there, that the sides that go back to the wall, are actually done at a 90 degree angle with the pocket screw. If you're not careful, it can lean over and you get a non-square joint, which just doesn't look professional. Here I start machining up for the wider of the radiator covers, so just doing the cross pieces. We use the sides from the first round of milling, putting the pocket hole jigs on again and cutting the pocket holes. Now I can glue screw together and keep them nice and flat so they work out the same as the other units. The beauty of these covers is they're cheap to make. They're just bits of off cuts of MDF that I had laying around the garage. It's not a high cost build or anything, but you can add your own personal touches to them. So as you'll see in a minute, I use some arcs and slats in them to give some visual appeal, but in essence you can make any pattern that kind of does it for you. This is just the one that worked for the client in this case. Next comes a load of sanding, so I try and pre-sand as much as I can whilst the edges are nice and easy to get to where they're square. I'm using the Festool RTS 400 for this. It's much easier to handle for those short edges than the Rotax, which is a bit too industrial for this purpose really. And all I'm trying to do here is just prep so that when the paint goes on and the MDF swells, it's as good as it can be before it goes to the painter. So these units here aren't going to be painted by me. There's a pro painter that's going to finish them off and make them look beautiful, but I just try and get them a little bit of a head start, make his life a little bit easier. Here you can see me filling in some of the little imperfections, again just to try and make it easier for the painter more than anything else. I put all that filler on and then knock it back with the sander just to keep nice flat edges that look perfect. Here I'm cutting some slightly thinner stock. This is 9mm, the other MDF's 18mm. So I use this with 3.5 centimeter widths to create the vertical kind of appeal. Next comes a router with a circle cutting jig. So I extend it right out so I can make almost like an arc rather than a circle. So this is quite a long way off the end of the kind of radiator cover to get that kind of arc shape. Key here is making sure the center of the arc is lined up with the center of the circle cutting jig, so that when it reaches either side, you'll see that it lines up. You'll see me double check it on the other side in a second. So I put the new cover down, measure out and mark the centers, put the router in the middle, and then manually adjust the length of that router so that when it touches each side, that arc is perfectly central. Just makes it look that little bit extra for the client. And I mark the bench so that when I flip it round for the bottom arc, I get the same setting, so it's as close to matching as I can make it. Next, I try and do it with the long radiator cover, and I learn to my despair that actually the arc size needed is way too large to fit within the garage, but it takes me many attempts to learn my mistake. Unfortunately, you can see here it's at max extent, so that's foul number one. I then extend the piece of wood, which is what I'm doing off camera at the minute, and try again and end up with foul number two. And yeah, I'm starting to realize at this point that it's not quite as easy as I thought it was going to be. So I decided to try use a bit of string and see if I can kind of make it work from one side of the garage to the other. But yeah, again, try number three doesn't work, and I didn't actually record it, but I went outside and the actual arc diameter was about 4 meters away, so it was never going to work in my little workshop, unfortunately. So I eventually gave up and went back to the old tried and tested jigsaw. So I cut, kind of drew out the pattern, carved it with a jigsaw, and then sanded it flat afterwards. And it worked out fine. There was no problem. Not quite as smooth as a router first time round, but the sander soon made short work of those blade marks in that MDF. You can see in these pictures, I'm using a mixture of different MDFs here. They're just bits I had, but the green stuff is MR, so it's moisture resistant, and then the normal browny beige kind of stuff is the standard MDF. It's all being painted, so you'll never notice a difference. In practice, the MR does give a slightly easier finish, but with sanding and a pro, it doesn't really matter that they're different types, no one will ever notice. Here I'm cutting slats, so you can see I cut loads and loads of these slats. So that I can do all the radiators and get them spaced equally. So I put them through the drum sander to make sure they're all uniform thickness, because the eye will really quickly notice if you have one that's slightly bigger than all the others. So the drum sander comes in dead handy for this little job here. And then I just clean up the front surface as well. Again, just make it a little bit easier for the painter. I think I'm far too kind to the painter in this case, but there's no harm in aiming for perfection. Here I do another couple of touch-ups just to make it as good as I can for the painter, and then I move on to the slats and spacing the slats out. So I find the center of the first slat and the center of the gap for the radiator cover, and then I just line one up with the other with a little bit of glue across the top and bottom. Once I've got the first in, I give it a couple of staples just to hold it in place. I think they're actually brads rather than staples. And then I then use the same spacer block from center out both sides to give a uniform thickness to each of those, and then just rub off any spare glue from the middle. Here I sand down the other one that I kind of previously put a little bit of filler on. Again, just make it as good as you can, find the centers, and attach all of the slats with the 20mm brads as per before. This project is quite a quick, simple, so I think in total there's probably about 2.5 hours in these three radiator covers. So not a big build by any means, but just something a little bit different just to show that you don't always have to work with high quality wood to get a good finish. Next up, I'm just prepping for the top really. I'm putting some pockets and some chop blocks in to screw the top on. Key here is making sure that the width of that top is not too long that it causes a sag. I then put a round over top and bottom on the top of the shelf and just give it another little quick sand for that painter. He's a lucky boy, isn't he, my painter? Here you can see the finished article in a sec as I flip it over. And there you go, radiator covers by the Woodwork Geek. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, give me a like, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next one.